Good morning, students. So let's see the differences between the compounds and the mixtures. So you have learnt about the compounds and you have learnt about the mixtures. So as you know that compounds are the pure substances, okay, and mixtures are considered as impure substances because their composition varies. Now understand this with the help of very simple example. See, we drink water every day. So water is made up of hydrogen and oxygen. So hydrogen is a gas, oxygen is a gas, and both of them supports burning. But what happens after chemically combining, when they combine and form water, then what happens? Water is a liquid, so properties change na, okay? So both the participants of the chemical reaction were gases. Now water is a liquid. Both of them supported burning and water stops burning. So the properties are also becoming different. So what happened? This is a complete new substance. Water is a complete new substance. Okay. So from wherever you will gather the water, it will have the same chemical formula, that is H2O. Okay. So water, you can see the everywhere the properties of this water will be same. Okay, and the properties is entirely different from the constituents. Okay, then water will have a fixed melting and boiling point. Okay, melting point and boiling point. Okay, and you cannot separate hydrogen and oxygen from water by simple physical methods. It has to be separated by the chemical process, and while formation of water, there may be energy released or energy absorbed like that. Okay, so something will be there. But what happens, you see the air. Now air is a mixture of gases, you know. So all the gases, nitrogen, oxygen, see, nitrogen 78%, oxygen 21%, and the other gases are in 1%, we know by the composition of air. Now when we breathe in, so when we breathe in, then what happens? So we take in oxygen and we exhale carbon dioxide, which is again mixed into the air. Now does air has any chemical formula? The answer will be no. Okay, then see, the oxygen hasn't changed its property. Okay, so whenever you will burn the candle, it will burn if it is kept in air. Why? Because the oxygen in air will support the burning. Okay, so that is the difference between the mixture and gas. Okay, and when the carbon dioxide or other things are mixed in a mixture, there is no exchange of energy. Okay, so air also doesn't have any fixed melting or boiling point. We can separate the different components. So such differences you can see in the page number 26 and 27 of your book. Okay, so the difference between compound and mixtures. Now we came to the section of separation of mixtures. Okay, what is the need of separating the mixtures and how the different mixtures are separated and what is the principle? Let's see that. Okay, now let's see the parts of the mixture. Okay, so the substances that make up the mixture, they are called the components of the mixture. So like if you will see a tea is an example of a mixture. Then the sugar, tea leaves, okay, water and milk are the components of the mixture. Okay, clear? Now what is the need for separation of the mixture? So first point is, we need to, since mixture is separable, we can separate the components of the mixture. So in nature, what happens when we get a mixture, and from that mixture, if we have to get the
things which we desire, okay, like or which are useful for us, then what happens? There is a need to remove the harmful and undesirable substances. So undesirable substances, what are they called? They are called as impurities. So when these impurities are removed, we get the desirable substances. Like suppose tea is there, okay? So what happens? Your mama strains the tea using a strainer. So what happens? Only the liquid tea which we desire to drink, that is in the cup, that falls in the cup, and the tea leaves which we don't desire, that is separated from the mixture. Got my point? Or you all eat butter, no? So when you eat butter, then what happened? So how the butter is made? So milk is churned or the curd is churned, and what happens? As a result, the fats separate and the watery components remain behind. So this fat is separated and frozen and salt is mixed, and what you get? You get the butter. This is the desired thing, and the impurities, the watery component, are discarded. Okay, so to remove the harmful and undesirable substances, there is a need to separate the mixture. Then it makes the second point clear. So to obtain a useful substance also, we need to separate the mixture. Okay, then when there is a need of obtaining pure samples, pure substance samples, why we need pure samples or pure substances? So when we make medicines or when we do experiments, so in laboratories, to do experiments, we need the pure substances. So there is a need to remove the impurities. So these three points, to remove the harmful and undesirable substances, okay, so to remove the harmful and undesirable substances or the impurities, to obtain the useful substance, and to obtain the pure sample of the substance, there is a need to separate the mixture. Okay, now let's see the principle of separation.